So large kidney stones, which we define usually as 1.5 to 2 centimeters in size, require some unique approaches. Now we treat those primarily with a percutaneous approach. And what that means is we make a very tiny mini incision over the kidney and go in with the camera directly into the kidney. We have special tools that allow us to break up and vacuum out the stones so we can clear all the pieces very effectively. Afterwards, we do keep the patients in hospital, but in the past it used to be a 5 or 6 day hospital stay, and the vast majority of our patients now get home the next day after the procedure. The biggest risk factor for kidney stones is not drinking enough fluid. And as simple as that sounds, we see this all the time. Patients come in, they get dehydrated, and the stones start to form. And it's simply there's crystals in the urine, and the crystals get too concentrated, and they stick together, and they form stones. So one of the things that we have to do with patients to work on preventing stones is work on fluid intake. And it can be a real challenge. Surgeons in particular are at risk for stones because they're often in the operating room for long periods of time where they can't drink fluids. But other examples would be teachers who are in a class and they don't want to be constantly taking bathroom breaks. I've had a highway patrolman who had recurrent stones because he was stuck on the highway for 8 hours a day and had no access to a bathroom. So there's unique challenges with each group of patients that we have to work with to try and overcome. Historically, males had more stones than females, but what we've seen in recent years is that trend has changed and it's evening out. It's almost 50-50 now. And we think that that has a lot to do with the lifestyle of women. Many women are in the workplace. Their diets have probably changed. And so the risk factors that men used to have, women likely have as well now too. And my own practice really has been pretty much a 50-50 mix of men and women with stones. One of the challenges that we have is often it's easier to get fast food and to get takeout food nowadays with everybody being so busy. Unfortunately, there's a lot of risk factors related to this. The high salt content in takeout food is a big-time risk factor for kidney stones. So when we see patients, we again have to work on their diet and on their treatment plan to see if we can modify some of these risk factors that are just inherent to the lifestyle that people have today. One thing with kidney stones, usually people know when they have one. They tend to get rip-roaring pain in the back that brings them into the emergency department. That being said, you know, anybody who has blood in the urine with no explanation for it should certainly go see their doctor and see if there's something going on. And it could be a kidney stone, although there's other more serious things that could also be going on. Anybody who sees a stone pass when they go to the bathroom should also be assessed because sometimes there's more stones to come. Patients who've had recurrent treatments elsewhere and are finding that they are not having success or not getting their stones cleared out, that would be a group of patients we'd be more than happy to see. A lot of our referrals do come from other urologists for patients who have very complex stone disease, and that's something that we really focus on is the treatment of these challenging stones.